Let's go quickly and see the foundation of approved covenant multiplication. Now, you see that I point you. I see the foundation of approved covenant multiplication. What is the approved? This is the accepted one. This is the true covenant multiplication. All our multiplication, they are fake because it's leading to zero. It's leading to damnation. Now, for you to have covenant multiplication, it must be with Jesus table. Say Jesus table.
Jesus table.
Jesus must take over. Without Jesus taking over, you are not going anywhere. Jesus must be in charge of your life. He must be your life now. When you want to have fruitfulness, genuine, authentic fruitfulness, our multiplication, Jesus must take over. That is the new dispensation. It is what is. It is the whole truth and not the truth. Without Jesus taking over your life, nothing. And make it clear in John 15. It is let us. He said, "Abide in me, I am you." He said, "If you abide in me, you shall be more fruit." But if you don't abide in me, he said, "On your own, you can do what? Nothing. You can do nothing on your own. It is only when you abide you can become fruitful. When you abide, you become fruitful, you become multiplied, you abide in the Lord Jesus." Because Jesus is the only way. The reason why Jesus is the foundation is because he's the only Savior. Do you remember that Savior? Jesus is the Savior of mankind. Without him, no one can be saved. John 3, verse 10. Let us go. He told me to the cross. He said, "Verily I say unto you, except a man be born again, he cannot do what? See." It did not come wrong. Then he also went and said, "Except not be baptized, except not be baptized of water and of spirit, he cannot do what? He cannot enter the kingdom of God." You have to be baptized of water and of Holy Ghost. You cannot enter. There must be Holy Ghost baptism and there must be water baptism. And that's why Mark 6:66 said, "When you repent, and you are baptized. You are what? Saved. When you repent, genuinely repent, and you are baptized, then you are saved." So you need Jesus. Jesus is the one that will reconcile us with God. Without Jesus, we cannot be talking of fruitfulness of men. Every other fruitfulness outside this is unacceptable. That one, though you be fruitful, though you multiply in the worldly sense, but what happened? It is unto destruction. Unto destruction. So the accepted one, the one that is approved, that is authentic, is Jesus Christ. And that's why I say Jesus Christ must take over your life. You must accept it. You must confess it. You must repent. And when you do that, and that's why I say new birth has come. You are born again. Number two, you must be in a new covenant. Hallelujah. It's all. But the other one is under eternal life. But the difficult aspect is that even though if you believe in the old covenant, you are not still going to make it. Of course, you remember Romans 3, verse 19. He said, "He has given us a law that no man can keep, so that every mouth will stop and every tongue will become guilty, everyone will become guilty before God." And in Galatians 3, 10 and 11, remember what he said? He said, "As it is written, curse be anyone that continueth not to do all that is written in the book of the law." He said, "By the law, no man can be justified. By the deed of the law, no man can be justified." So what does that mean? It means you must be in the new covenant. Jeremiah 31, 13, 14. Let us say. He said, "I will make a new covenant. Not as the man. In this one, in the new covenant. If you are not in the new covenant, there is a problem. And who is the new covenant? Jesus. Jesus is the one that puts you in the new covenant. You must be registered. You must be in the new covenant. So when you are in that new covenant, now you are in the lineage of the covenant, blessing of fruitfulness and communion that is accepted. The approval. So you see, we have to be in that new covenant. Because that is the only one that is approved. And that is why you say when we read, go to one for someone to bring you. The same way we read, he said, you can keep the covenant. Because all believers will not keep the covenant. They are covenant breakers. Someone will tell you, if you can look at it, you can someone will tell you, very well, we are looking for covenant keepers. Read 18 for me.
To such as keep his covenant.
To such as keep his covenant.
And to those that remember his covenant.
To those that remember his covenant.
To do them.
To do them, thank you. You see? It's very sweet. Like this church, many of them are still locked up in the old covenant. They are waiting for Jesus to come the first time. They don't believe that Jesus has come. They are still waiting. Where Jesus has come and died and to repent and is coming back the second time. We are waiting for the second one. We are waiting for the first one. You see the problem they have? And that is why I was supposed to look at them and say, oh, he said, I can be a record. Are these people my people? They have zeal for God. He said that they are not done according to knowledge. God has said that they are going to establish their own. God said this is not the way. They say it's the way. Now you tell them the first time. Why you change the way? You have no power to change the way. That one way is what? We must go now. And what is the old covenant? You know it? The old covenant is circumcision. Circumcision. When you are circumcised, you are not equal. And you continue to obey God. In the new covenant, you circumcision order. Circumcision is not. Whether you circumcise or you're not circumcised, is it a law? What is the covenant? Jesus. Jesus is what is the covenant in the new covenant. That is all that is the covenant. Jesus. You can come in not circumcised. But just accept Jesus. So what the person said. Then you receive the circumcision of the Holy Ghost. You are baptized in the Holy Ghost. You see, when you receive that, you are baptized in the water and the Holy Ghost, you are good to go. That is all. So it is a whole check for every person, both believers and all believers. So you see, God is fair. God is a good God. And that is why he made it clear in his word in 1 Timothy 2, verse 1. He said, who desires for every person to enjoy the divine fruitfulness and manifestation of God. This is what we are doing. What has happened to you? What has happened to you? 2 Corinthians 4 verse 4. He said, the God of this world has blinded your eyes. Ephesians 2 verse 2. Read the conference for the blessing. Let's enjoy. The God of this world. You see what God has done, have caused them to begin to be spirit, because their eyes have been blinded. It's not that you read the Bible.
2 Corinthians
4
verse 4.
Yes.
In whom the God of this world.
Now this is who the God of this world
have blinded their mind.
Have blinded their mind.
For them
who
believe not.
Now listen. For them their spiritual eyes have blinded. You know what? It's a mind. For them who do what? Who believe not? Now, not Ephesians. So, who will be blind? Those that do not believe. It's not people who we are not blind. We can see. Ephesians 2, verse 2. It's not
Ephesians 2.
Yes.
In which we once walked according to the course of the world.
Yes. In which we once walked. We were there before. We were Gentiles before. We walked in that one in the time.
According to the prince of the power of the
world. According to If you go to John, where John said was at home, in John 8:44, he gave all the children of the Spirit to Satan. He said, "Here is the fact. When they say that the seed of Abraham, he said, you're the seed of Abraham. If you be a seed of Abraham, you will not want to kill him." Let's go and read John 8:44 for us. Let's read it. John 8:44. He said, "You are not a seed of Abraham. If you say you're a seed of Abraham, you want to kill him." Yes, your father said that he was a father of the faith. There is no cheating. Yeah.
Verse
44. Yes.
He was a father of your father. He was a wanderer from the beginning. And abode not in the truth.
There's no truth in him.
Because there is no truth in him.
You know, like sons, the sons of the prophet, your son, is the spiritual father. You see? So now, when you are obedient to Satan, you are in the center of it. You are his sons. He has given you to follow them. So when he talks, they do what he said. That is what I'm talking about. I need a match. So you know the next one, what happened? The new righteous. So they are not anywhere around the mountains. So you want to raise that new righteousness. That's a big problem. Romans 10 verse 4. Christ is the end of the law of righteousness. To everyone that believes, to all those that believe, Christ is the end of the law of righteousness. Today, the people of the world, the unbelievers, Gentiles, many of them, they still believe in the law of righteousness. What is the law of righteousness? That is when you obey the Lord, when you believe the Lord, and you are obedient to the Lord, you are righteous by the Lord. So the child, you see them pray several, they do this, they strong way, they don't want, they want to keep all the laws. Can anybody keep all the laws? No person except Jesus. There is no person. No pope, no bishop, no deacon. Say the word of God. Genesis to the say you need to go. It is not possible. So God, that's why God said, I give them the law, you cannot keep. So that every man will become with his fault, and everyone will become guilty before him. So he brought someone that can do it. And the only reason why Jesus has to do it, Jesus Christ is the law, or you don't know. He is the law. Jesus is the law. Psalm 119, verse 142. Read that for us, sir. Is anyone willing to keep the law? Even the man
killed the man. They killed the man. The man that killed the man was killed. Not the man of who we escaped. So there was no escaping. If the man that even was able to kill the man was killed, is it you that would not be missing? It is funny. The person that was able to kill him, they killed him. That was a great decision. Satan didn't understand. They would not have killed the man. If he knew too well that killing the law is going to save the man, he would have been telling Jesus, just stay like that. But God made the deal. When they kill him, they were happy. Yes, yes, we don't kill him. And the Lord of the Lord, you cannot kill the law. The law is the truth. When you kill truth, what happened? He said, no one can do nothing against the truth but for the truth. If you kill the truth, did grant bury the truth, come on, 3 days later, the truth will be resurrected. That is Jesus. So you see, there's nothing you can do. You can only walk with the truth. And that is why as Christians, we live in the truth, we walk in the truth, we speak the truth. 3 John 1, 3 and 4. 2 John 3 and 4. So you see, you must do everything in the truth. Your life depending on the truth. Jesus is the truth. So he says, you must be the new righteousness. Not the new righteousness. New holiness. You see, Jesus is the one that gives you righteousness. He's the one that gives you holiness. He's the one that gives you goodness. You cannot be righteous without Jesus. You cannot be holy without Jesus. You cannot be good without Jesus.
Jesus is the foundation of one profession. The foundation of the Jesus is the foundation.
salvation is about anything about you. Now, we take another one. Number seven, the advantage of the resurrection power. Woo! You see, when we talk about resurrection power, we say taking advantage of the resurrection power. The resurrection power in Revelation 5 and 7, there are seven elements of it. If you don't believe in Christ and his resurrection power, how can you take belief of it? Huh? If you don't believe in Christ, how can you take belief of the resurrection power? You see, we need the resurrection power of Jesus Christ to be able to operate in this pattern. That seven main pattern is the comprehensive chance of salvation. You need it, not the third pattern. You need the comprehensive, that seven main pattern. Power, strength, blessing, glory, power. All of them, you need them all packaged together. You need them. Somebody who is now in the kingdom, who does not believe in the resurrection power of Jesus. Somebody that is saying Jesus has not died in Jesus. How will you take the view of that? You cannot. So you see, the person cannot have this fruitfulness of the people. The person cannot have that. The problem of the family of the Jesus. Then the last one we take it. Advanced faith will give you advanced multiplication. Fruitfulness of the future. Advanced faith. If you don't even believe in the faith in Jesus Christ as your faith, how will you make it? Say the church and you are faith. Who is the church? The church of the righteousness. And the righteousness that is acceptable to you, the one of Jesus Christ. So if you are not believing, you don't believe in that righteousness of Jesus. You believe in another kind of righteousness, like the Pharisees and Sadducees. Are you not the problem? Somebody that believes Jesus Christ, in your righteousness must exceed that of the Pharisees and Sadducees for you to be believed. So if you don't believe in Jesus for now, so you see, so you must have advanced faith. And that faith is the one talk of your faith. It's in the church of my faith. And what did the Word of God say in Hebrew 11 verse 6? He said, without faith, it is impossible to do what? Please God. And he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and is the rewarder of those that diligently seek. God is the rewarder of those that diligently seek. So if you are talking of fruitfulness and multiplication, you must believe in Jesus Christ. If you believe that, you